Welcome to Developing with DocuSign. I'm Lauren Dunn, Senior Salesforce Advocate on the DocuSign Developer Advocacy Team. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to install the DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce package from the Salesforce App Exchange, connect your DocuSign and Salesforce accounts, and add DocuSign features on Salesforce objects. And last but not least, I'm going to show you how to send a document for signing. There are a few prerequisites before we get going. You need a Salesforce org, you need to enable My Domain in that Salesforce org, and you need to have a DocuSign account or a free developer account. In these examples, I'm using a Salesforce developer org and a developer account from DocuSign. So let's get going. Okay, so I have logged into my Salesforce developer account and it has brought me to the home page. There are two ways to access the App Exchange. You can go into your home quick find and type in App Exchange and access it this way. Or you could go to appexchange.salesforce.com and it will bring up the App Exchange homepage. Once I'm in the App Exchange, I am going to search for DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce. We've done a massive cleanup of our products and this is the all singing, all dancing product that you need. Once I have accessed it, select Get It Now and follow the prompts to install into your org. Installation can take up to about 20 minutes, so go grab yourself a cup of coffee. You will get an email notification saying the app has installed. Now that your app is installed, let's get it connected to DocuSign. Click on your Apps Launcher and type in DocuSign. Open up the DocuSign Apps Launcher, and here's where we will connect your DocuSign and Salesforce. So we want to go to Advanced Options because I am using a developer account, both a Salesforce and a DocuSign account. So I'm going to click Login to Demo Account. If you were doing this in a production org, you would click Login to DocuSign. You will then log into your account using your email address and you will enter in your password as well. After entering in my username and password, my account is now selected and I'm following the prompts. I'm going to authorize Salesforce access, and that's it. I'm connected and authorized with DocuSign. Next, it brings you to your configuration page. I have eSign enabled, and then also the main one I'm going to focus on is user management as well. In a later video, I will talk about DocGen and Negotiate. For now, user management. Just because you have installed your app and you provisioned it for all users doesn't mean all users have access. You have to give them access manually. So to do that, you click User Management and click Management. As you can see, I have access, but I want to add another user. So to add more users into this, you can select a user and search by name or email. You can select by profile or a permission set. So I'm going to select user and type in test. As you can see, I have a test user here. I'm going to select that and add the user. Now that I have done that, that user has user privileges and they have the permission sets assigned to them in Salesforce. You can do this for all users individually, or you can do it, as you saw, by profile. If you want to give someone administration privileges, you can edit their permission and you can have manage DocuSign account. Best practice says only give administration privileges to those who have been trained on DocuSign administration. Otherwise, you have a whirligig of trouble on your hands. So now that I've shown you how to connect your DocuSign and Salesforce and shown you how to set up a user, I'm now going to show you how to create a template, apply it to an object, and create a custom button. First thing you're going to want to do while still in your DocuSign Apps Launcher app, go over to DocuSign Envelope Templates and select New. Give your template a name. I'm going to give it purchase order and a data source. Where do you want this template? I'm going to select opportunity because it is a purchase order. I'm going to select next. Then you're brought to this workflow. You need to add your document, so having your template already made on a Word document really helps. So I'm going to upload my document. Then I'm going to click Next, and I'm going to select the recipients who are going to receive this template. So add a recipient. You can select a record field, a related list, a user or contact, related sources, So I've selected someone who has to sign, but if I didn't want them to sign and they only needed to receive a copy, these are the different types of actions. Needs to sign, in-person signer, receives a copy, needs to view, etc. So I'm going to click add. And then here's where I can add in an email subject. I'm editing the message a little. I'm quite happy with that, so I'm going to click next. Here is where I pull in fields. I'm going to add a field. It's going to be on the opportunity record because that's where I'm setting all this up. And what is the field I want to populate? So if I want order number, and then it populates as opportunity owner number. I'm going to select write back. Reason for that is I want, in case there is an error, the customer to edit that purchase order number so it will come back correctly into my Salesforce org. However, if they have not given me a purchase order number, this also allows them to put the purchase order number in there and it updates Salesforce for me. There's no manual touch at all. I'm also going to have it as a required field. Purchase order number is very important on a purchase order. So for this, I'm going to make sure it is a required field so I cannot finalize anything until they have given me that purchase order number and that is filled out. I'm going to click save. I'm quite happy with this and I'm going to click next. Now I'm going to place that merge field onto my purchase order that I uploaded. So I'm going to head over to merge fields and there is the merge field I have. Right there. If I get into this stage and I'm like, oh, I've missed a merged field, I can still add on right here. I can find something and I can add it in. I can make it required or read only, and then I can change the format if I want to change the fonting or anything like that. So for this, I am going to fill out some details. Obviously, I need a signature towards the end, so I'm going to drag and drop. It's really, really simple. I'm going to give the name right here. The company is going to go right here. And I'm going to add the title of the person. And I'm also going to put the date it was signed. If I had two signers, like I have here, I would have a second drop down and I can add in more recipients if I want to again here. Just because you didn't fill it out previously, when you get to this step, if you realize you need to add something in, that's totally okay. You can do that. You can add in edit recipients and you can add another person. Another cool thing is you can set a signing order as well. So the owner has to sign first and then the new recipient has to sign afterwards. This all looks okay to me. I'm going to save and close. Next, I can add additional options, such as an automatic reminder. So, if you want to remind someone to sign every single day if they haven't signed it. And then, when the envelope expires, sometimes orders are sent out with discounts, privy to the time of the quarter that they're at. So, you can change this. I'm going to have mine expire after 2 days. You can update the sending experience. It's automatically defaulted to default, but you can click Quick Send. Quick Send sends the documents with no chance to change anything. So be mindful of what you are trying to achieve with your document. One of the important things to know here is your document write back. Do you save the completed documents to the opportunity, or do you save the certificate of completion to the opportunity? I like to save both. And the reason why I like to save both is because it's there in the record should I need it, or if I have won the lottery and gone on a Caribbean cruise, no one has to wonder where these documents are. They're saved within the opportunity record. Another thing to select is what type of file name do you want? I like to put the email subject, the envelope status, and the PDF right there, only because then it gives everyone an overview of what's in that document. So I'm quite happy with this, and I'm going to move to my custom button. So if you've been around Salesforce for a while, you'll remember JavaScript buttons and having to custom code the buttons to send a document. DocuSign has taken all the hard work out. We've done all the heavy lifting for you. We've made it so easy just to create a custom button. So with this, I'm going to label my button. I'm going to call it PO. And I'm going to select which page layouts I want to add this onto. So I'm going to select all of them for now. And then I'm going to save and finish. And that's it. My custom button has been created. Now let me show you what it looks like on the opportunity page. So here I am on the opportunity page. I'm going to select open opportunity. And here is that custom button that we just made. I'm going to select that purchase order. Here's the document. So here I am on recipients. The sender gets to review all this information. I am going to select next. It brings me into the template just to make sure everything looks okay. Looks great to me. And I'm just going to click send. Boom, it's sent. Now let's go see what it looks like over in the recipient's email. So here it is in the email. You can review the document. I'm going to continue. I'm going to put in the purchase order number. I'm going to put in company name, Disney World. And then I'm going to look at this. Yep, looks good. Going to sign I'm a Disney princess because that's my title and a date. I'm going to finish. And that's it. So I put in a purchase order number into this document. It's supposed to translate in to my opportunity. So here it is here. Purchase order number is not there. Okay, let's refresh. Go back into details. And there's my order number. It translated from my DocuSign document into my Salesforce object. If I scroll over here, you can also see the purchase order with all the details and it's signed. And that, my friends, is how you integrate DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce into your Salesforce org, set up your users within Salesforce for your DocuSign, create a DocuSign envelope, send that envelope on an opportunity, and receive that envelope back. So now that you've seen how easy it is to get started with DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce, here are some getting started resources. DocuSign University has loads of free self-paced courses you can utilize. My favorite is a DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce specialist. We also have a developer center where you can access SDKs and code examples, our admin guide for a deep dive into setting up your DocuSign for Salesforce integration, and DocuSign eSignature for Salesforce meetups. These are once a month free meetups where you can come and meet other customers of DocuSign and share some knowledge and hopefully gain some knowledge. I'm going to leave you with a whole load more resources. There's blogs, events, newsletters, there's a forum. Obviously, you're watching this on YouTube, but please don't forget to connect with us on social media. We have a Twitter account and also LinkedIn. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Developing with DocuSign videos. And thank you for watching.